Hey guys, assalamu alaikum. May peace be upon you. This is Suresh, and today we have team of Cloud Pages with us. What is Cloud Pages? I have written a one-line definition of it inside the description. It's a WordPress server manager, and we have team here with us, and we are going to learn more about how this product works and what are the hosting types that we have right now in the market. So let's welcome from the team members of Cloud Pages, Usman Nasir and Shoaib Khan Khattar.
Thank you, Nes. Welcome.
How are you guys?
Hi, we are fine. How are you?
I'm fine too. So today we are going to discuss about Cloud Pages, and I have few questions regarding that. So let's begin. So first of all, when I saw this deal, there were many questions popped up in my mind regarding hosting, because I'm not a server expert. I use hosting for my websites, but as a front-end user, right? So I don't know much technical things about hosting. Yeah, as far as management is concerned, I am managing my site since last 3 years. So I would like to, if you show us that how many types of servers and hosts exist in the market right now, such as we have heard about shared hosting, cloud hosting, managed WordPress, VPS. So can you just explain in brief to us?
First of all, thank you, Unes, for inviting us to this webinar. And actually, we have also been receiving lots of questions regarding this. And even some people bought our deal considering that it's a hosting deal.
Okay.
But Cloud Pages is, you can say that it's not directly a hosting company. You can say right now there are two major hosting types, shared hosting and cloud hosting. So most of the people are, they know about shared hosting. They go and buy a hostgator, SiteGround, and they easily host their sites on cPanel control panel. But Cloud Pages, the first thing is that Cloud Pages is not an hosting service, or we don't sell servers.
Okay.
You can use Cloud Pages to manage your LAMP stack. In terms of live speed, they call it LEMP. So you can buy a server from any cloud provider like DigitalOcean, AWS, UpCloud, and then you can install Cloud Pages on top of it to manage your server. So another client asks that how it will benefit me, like what is the difference between hosting and Cloud Pages. So basically it will save you time for managing your WordPress sites. It will make it easy for you to manage your WordPress site. Our stack will install on your server, and you can easily manage and deploy your WordPress sites with Lightspeed cache pre-installed.
Okay, so that was the quite, I think, जिसे उर्दू में कहते हैं ना जामे आपने एक सामने रख दिया हमारे सामने. So I pretty much understood that what Cloud Pages is, and for this, what type of server we need, right? We need a VPS, right? Because
you can call it on VPS, bare metal servers, but the only requirement is it should be Ubuntu 22.04, the operating system.
Okay. So that should be the operating system to run Cloud Pages on top of it, right? Okay. Yes. So we pretty much understood that what Cloud Pages is, and I have another question that if I'm a beginner, right? I can manage my site. I already manage websites on shared hosting, or let's say WordPress managed hosting. So is there any specific technical knowledge that I need to use Cloud Pages on my server, or I can use as a beginner?
Installing Cloud Pages is pretty straightforward. Like if you have used cPanel extensively, or if you have used cPanel plus another normal control panel, there is one single command that you have to run after purchasing your VPS or bare metal server. You just run that command, and cloud pages server side agent will be installed, and then you can just deploy your WordPress site with few clicks. I think your WordPress site will be ready in 1 to 2 minutes after installing cloud pages.
Okay.
And we have extensive documentation on it, on how you can deploy WordPress, and I think it will be easy for even a beginner as well.
Okay, so can we have a live look? If you can share screen and show us that how the interface looks and how this cloud pages can be used to manage server, or what are the features inside you have developed to manage websites and that.
Yes, I would like to not invite Shweb for a complete demo, so that.
Hello everyone. Thank you, Vinas, for inviting us for this webinar, and thank you, Sumant sir, for letting me.
You can share
screen to start a demo of product.
Okay, so I will be popping in if needed. So please allow the screen sharing, right? So the screen will be visible. Now it's not visible.
Can my screen is visible for you?
Yeah, it's visible. Now we can see screen.
Okay, as Usman sir already mentioned that you need to set up cloud pages on your server. You just need a VPS or a dedicated server with Ubuntu 20.04. So I assume that you have a VPS. You have a VPS from any cloud provider, VPS provider like Hetzner or Dio. I got one from the DigitalOcean. First of all, let me set up project. Basically, what cloud pages does? Cloud pages start from setting up a project. What is a project? Project is a basically a container under which you can manage your servers, your billing, your team members, and all. You can manage each and everything under project. Let me set up first a project for this new setup. To setting up a project is very easy and a few click process in cloud pages. Here on the top bar of my browser screen, you can see here is a button, create new project. Just click on the create new project. On the next screen, you just have to provide a name for the project. Write any name for the project, test project, any name that you want to give, and click on the create project button. Then the project dashboard will be in front of you. Here you can see this is the project dashboard, which have a lot of options in the left side menu, and you can in front page, in the front dashboard, you can see your plan is stated here. As I just set up this project and I didn't have any plan on this, so plan is not selected. I would like to go on another project that I already set up to with an agency plan, like this Shoaib. This project have an plan, agency plan. Set in the next step, you have to set up server. Set up cloud pages on your server is very easy and a clean and few clicks process. In left side menu, you can see there are a lot of buttons, and on the top you can see a deploy server button. Click on the deploy server button. In cloud pages, what we did, we mentioned all instructions. We try to mention all instructions in every installation and deployment, like in WordPress deployment and in server deployment. We try to mention all instructions so everything is clear to the user. Like here, if you read these installation node, everything will be clear to the user who is going to install or set up a new server with CloudPages? Like, first of all, as Usman sir already mentioned in the start, that CloudPages need a VPS or a dedicated server. Provider does not matter which, from which provider you are getting your VPS. The thing matter is the Ubuntu 20.04 operating system. You must have Ubuntu 20.04 operating system on your VPS or a dedicated server. And you must have these port open, like 80 TCP 443, TCP 443, UDP and 2083. 2083 is the dedicated port for the cloud pages. Below all these instructions, you can see you have to provide some required details, like server type, for which server type you want to set up your server. Here you have two types, Lightspeed Enterprise and Open Lightspeed. If you have a Lightspeed Enterprise license, then you can go with the Lightspeed Enterprise. Otherwise, you can go with the free version of Lightspeed, that is Open Lightspeed. Here you can add any name to your server, like I add here, you have to provide your server IPv4 address. I already set up a DigitalOcean droplet for this. Here is the IP of my server. After providing all detail, just click on the deploy server button. You can see after clicking on the deploy server button, here are some instructions you have to follow to done this deploy server part. First of all, you have to log into any SSH client like PuTTY or Bitwise, any client you are comfortable with. Like for this tutorial, I have Bitwise SSH client. Let me log in as a root in this server. Then what you have to do, open the terminal from your SSH client and copy this installation command for cloud pages and paste on your server. This installation process will take few minutes, like 15 to 20, maximum 15 to 20. It will install Lightspeed web server, MariaDB, and all other required packages on your server. And this process will take 15 minutes. We will move toward another server that is already deployed to show you the next step, how you can set up a WordPress website, how you can deploy a WordPress website on your server. Here in my list server section, you can see this server is under deploy. This server, I am deploying this server, the last one, this one, the IP with 139. You can see here, the process is going on. This server one, I have already deployed this server. In this server, we will know how to deploy a WordPress site. To deploy a WordPress site, once your server deployment done, you can see this dashboard. Here you can see create website, list website. Let me clear this, that cloud pages is dedicatedly for the WordPress website management, but you can also manage any other type of website as well with cloud pages. Like we have a create website option through which you can create any type of website and host with the cloud pages. For this demo, we will dedicatedly go for the WordPress manager. So to deploy a WordPress site, just click on the WordPress manager. I already have some sites on this server. To deploy a new site, just click on the green deploy WordPress button. This will take you to the installation configuration screen. In installation configuration screen, you have to provide some detail to deploy a new WordPress site. Like first you have to deploy, you have to provide what title you want for the your WordPress site. Like I will give it title one. What domain you want to use for the for deploying this WordPress? Like we can say live demo dot cloud pages dot cloud. You can change path from here, and also which version of WP you want to install on this website. If you want to transfer your website from any other server and you want to go with some older version of WP, you can select any of them from here. But I, for this demo, I will go with 5.7.2. Here we in plugin or theme option, we provide the initial setup with following option. Like if you want to set up a basic WordPress site with LS cache only, you can select the first option. If someone preferred the classical editor, he can select the WordPress LS cache plus classical editor. If someone is going to set up a new WooCommerce store, then he can choose the last option, WordPress plus Lightspeed cache plus WooCommerce. I will go with the basic one. Here you have to provide some detail. Using those, you will log into the admin dashboard of your WordPress. Like you have to provide a username. Like here I provide the admin. Here you have to provide your email. And in the last section, you have to set a strong password. In the last section, update section, you can enable or disable updates for plugin, code updates, and themes. You can, the first option is automatic updates. These are the core updates, core update for WordPress. Like you can enable the minor and security update. That will be done automatically, and you can also enable all the update minor and major. And you, if you want to do manually, you can go with the disable. Same in the plugin section, you can enable all the updates for plugin, and also you can disable, and so forth for the themes. After providing all these detail, just press the black deploy WordPress button. You can see a message here, deployment started. During the deployment, you can see the progress, like what is going on the backend, like obtaining SSL, parent website created, and so on until the process completed. This process will also take a few minutes, like 3, 4, 5 minutes. Downloading the core updates, downloading core WordPress core files and installing. This is almost second last step on the backend. Now you can see the process complete. One process is completed, you can see this WP Manager dashboard on your screen. In WP Manager dashboard screen, we have a lot of options. Like we have four tabs here: journal, plugin, themes, and staging. What you can do in journal, first let me tell about these six. You can see the WP version, PHP version. If you want to change to upgrade PHP version or downgrade PHP version, you can check PHP version from here and change from the backend. Then you can enable disable LS cache plugin from here. This is just toggle button to toggle. You can enable disable with one click. same like debugging. If you have any issue in WordPress and you want to enable WordPress debug mode, you can enable from here. Search engine indexing, one of the more important thing. You can also enable, say, like you are going to deploy a demo site, you do not want that it will index in search engine, so you can disable from here. Maintenance mode, if you are going to do some work and like to put the site in the maintenance mode, you can enable from here. Here we have four button. Open, what we can do from open, you can access your website. We also have a file manager in the world. Here you can see we have a file manager button. What you can do from file manager, you can create any folder, create any file, compress any file or folder, extract any file. All the documentation is present in the our knowledge base section. And then what you can do from the upload, we use the SFTP variant for upload. You can just click on the upload button. It will take you to the this screen. From here, you can see this is your SFTP account username. You can change password from here, clicking here the change password, and then log into the FileZilla or any to upload any file on your server. Documentation is available on in our knowledge base section. We have a login. This button will auto login to you to the WP admin dashboard. And we also have a Git manager plugin. What you can do from the plugin section, you can enable any plugin or disable any plugin. You can delete any plugin or update any plugin from here. Same in the case of theme. From theme, you can also enable, you want to disable any theme and enable any other, you can do directly from here. No need to log in WP admin and do it from there. You can do from here and also delete anything from here. We also have a staging, one-click staging feature. To create a staging site, just click on the staging button, provide the name, provide the name and a domain, and a domain or a subdomain you want to. The process will start. It will also take some time to complete that. It need to cover all the copy, create a new site, then copy, and then copy database, files, and all other things to the staging site. Done from my side for a demo. If you have any other question about the process, then I will guide you.
We have a question from Swapnil that we can only deploy WordPress sites.
As I already mentioned, you can host any type of site with Cloud Pages, not only WordPress site.
Okay, so Swapnil, your question is answered. You can host any type of website, but it has a WordPress installation feature also, so you can use install WordPress site also. Okay, so
yes, I would like to add here that they can install any sort of PHP based application. Yeah, they can create a normal website from Cloud Pages. They can upload the PHP script, create database, and they can host any sort of PHP website. For WordPress, we have created a dedicated WordPress manager and installer to make their life easy with WordPress sites.
Okay, so I also read somewhere that there is something security is also involved in Cloud Pages. So how this works? As we see that there are many bot attacks on WordPress sites. So what is the security environment? That we have many third-party tools like website antivirus or let's say firewalls. So do we need them, or we don't need them, or we can still instead of cloud page security, we can install that.
If I speak from my personal experience regarding WordPress security, I have seen many people using WordFence and other sort of security plugins. Yeah. And I think that these plugins slow down WordPress site, because WordPress is already very bloated when you install the plugins, WooCommerce yeah. plugin and other sort of plugins. So WordFence really slowed down this site. For that, I personally recommend that they should use a mod security. Mod security pretty much do the same thing at server level. And okay. the WordFence does it at application level. And apart from that, we also have a recapture feature which is built into Lightspeed server, which they can enable. And they can also use Bubble Wrap. Bubble Wrap basically containerize their applications. So that, for example, if one site is hacked on a server, it does not affect the other sites.
Okay. So that was about, we just saw the demo, and I am able to understand it easily, as the Shoaib has explained. So I think that's pretty much easy and not that too much technical that I need some type of coding or like that thing, right? So it's quite easy, and with the documentation, it becomes more easy. So what is the hosting or VPS provider that you recommend? This is my personal question, because this is a very big confused point when we have to decide that what hosting provider we should use.
I think that's totally depends upon the user. For example, okay. some people will be comfortable with even Hetzner Cloud. And for my personal experience, I noticed that Hetzner Cloud is slightly slow. That's my experience. I don't know what others think. Okay. And some for development, you guys can also use LightSail. That's a product of AWS. And okay. You also know DigitalOcean is also there, DigitalOcean UpCloud. That totally depends upon the end user. Some people also install on bare metal servers too.
Okay. So my next question is about team. Who is behind Cloud Pages? How many team members you have? Is this your first project, or you had previous projects? And if yes, what are their projects? So that I would like to know.
Yes, many people asked this question, and we are all also the same team behind CyberPanel. And CyberPanel has been around for almost 4 years now. And I started it back in 2017. But it also have a lots of features. But the same question that you asked earlier, that how easy it will be for a newbie to deploy WordPress site. So as you can see that on Cloud Pages, it is very easy. Like, you can deploy a WordPress site with few clicks. CyberPanel offered a lot of features that confused many end users. They used to get lost with lots of options. And also CyberPanel is open source as well. We have learned a lot, and it's a great community. So then from that experience, we thought that we need to do something similar, simpler, for non-tech users, like the marketing guys in the industry, the freelancers and web agency owners.
Okay, so this is more useful for agencies and freelancers, and the individual also who run and manage multiple sites, multiple PHP applications, or let's say he has his own many various WordPress blogs, you can say, right? Especially I would like to mention bloggers and affiliate marketers who specifically run blogs on WordPress only, right? Because that is the preferable platform, most preferred platform for running blogs. Okay, so you had some past experience and user feedbacks on the basis of which you decided to create this Cloud Pages. How this thought came in your mind? How this thought came in your mind, right? So I would like to ask you that the basic features are ready right now in the cloud pages. Do you decide anything further, anything on roadmap which is now not present in cloud pages and you plan to develop in future? That is on your roadmap.
Yes, of course. Our roadmap was made live, I think, 2 days ago.
Okay.
Yes. So we would like to bring PHP managers, cron job manager, and various other features to further automate everything. And one thing that I would also like to mention that these days people are mostly interested in improving their page speed scores, because you know that Google have made this ranking factor.
Yeah. But
they don't take care of high traffic. Like when their site receive huge amount of traffic, then some people don't know that what should they do. So light speed cache plugin and light speed server basically take cares of that, because light speed cache is a full page server level caching, and when there is a cache hit, server don't have to fork the PHP process, and the forking PHP process is one of the most expensive process during a request life cycle.
Okay, so it consumes more of you can say server resources, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so regarding your and you have anything else to share what was in roadmap, or we can just share the link of roadmap in the comment box so people can go and walk through that, right?
Actually, lots of people requested server level permissions. I think we are going to bring that as well, server level and the application level permissions for team members. So apart from that, I think Shoaib can share the roadmap link, and people can see our live roadmap as well.
Okay. Or you can share screen also with roadmap.
Shoaib.
So guys, meanwhile, if you have any question, you can drop in the comment box and we will try our best to answer it. And after the live stream also, you can drop your questions in the comment box. I will tag the team members over there to reply your questions. And if you have any questions regarding VPS or hosting or let's say cloud pages, right? And one more question I have about support, that because such hosting related stuff needs a lot of support, right? Because as we just discussed that this is made for non-tech person, right? So sometimes what happens, the task is simple and option feature is available in the dashboard, but user somehow miss that or somehow not able to find that feature. So the support tickets increases, right? So how support is handled? Is there any dedicated support team with you? And I would like to know more about it.
Yes, support is a very important factor in the hosting industry. Yeah. We do have a support team, and our current clients even can see that we are really fast in responding to their queries. So we have also been handling, I think our same team handling support for 2 to 3 years now. So they are really expert guys with the support. I see a new question. Is Lightspeed available here? I think if they are asking about Lightspeed servers, then both Open Lightspeed and Lightspeed Enterprise are supported with cloud pages. So they can install with the Lightspeed Enterprise as well, but for that they need a Lightspeed Enterprise license, which they can purchase from Lightspeed store.
Okay, so I will also recommend the users who are commenting to allow B.Live to show your name to us so we can see your name, because this stream is live on 4 to 5 places on Facebook. So we don't know where your comment is, but you can allow Facebook to show your name to Be Live, so we can see over here. Okay. So that was the question, and that was pretty much everything we covered. Anything else? If you think that we missed out, so you can cover that. I got the roadmap link. So cloudpages.cloud. Just a second. Just give me a second, and I will open over here. Okay. So what I'm doing, I'm just sharing my screen for this roadmap thing, right? Okay. So. So we have multiple things, guys. We have dropped the link inside comment box, and you can go and see this roadmap on Trello. And you can see that PHP edits, fixed permission stack, one-click Lightspeed restart, server-level permission, Redis one-click setup, and PHP extension installation. These all are in progress and under development. And the pending tasks are restore backup, backup setup, PHP MyAdmin, Google Drive backup, integration, Cloud Pages API access, website level SSH, and 2FA. So that's in pending, and team is still considering them to develop. And of course, you can go and suggest them multiple things that what you need, so they can shape up their roadmap according to it. And obviously, they need feedbacks from users so they can shape up the product. So there's one more question in the comment that I just joined the live. If we compare CloudWays with Cloud Pages, what are the difference?
Yes, one of the major difference is that Cloud Pages natively support Lightspeed servers.
Okay.
That's one of the major difference. And in Cloud Pages, you can bring any cloud provider and install Cloud Pages, even on the bare metal servers.
Okay, but I think Cloud Pages, CloudWays, as it's compared, I think CloudWays, they have or they also resell the servers from, let's say, AWS or Google Cloud or Volta, right? So what they do, they provide such things as Cloud Pages with hosting, right? I think, if I'm not wrong.
They have directly integrated with the cloud provider APIs. That's why you are limited to the providers they have integrated with.
So basically, with Cloud Pages, you can use any hosting provider. And what CloudWays does is that CloudWays have already 4 to 5 cloud server providers, and you can use any of them. Okay. So anything else you need to cover?
Yes, as I was saying, the another major difference is Lightspeed servers. The Cloud Pages natively supports Lightspeed servers, both of them, Open Lightspeed and Lightspeed Enterprise.
I think pretty much everything we covered, guys. If you have any other question, you can drop in the comment box, and the team will be there. I'll be tagging them to reply you guys. So guys, do check out Cloud Pages. I already provided the link below in the comment box, and you can ping me directly or directly message the team also. So guys, thank you for joining. We'll meet in the next video. And do share your feedback about Cloud Pages. What do you think about this deal? Thank you guys for joining.
Thank you.